Who has the best news? Who has the best public affairs? Who has the best science? Who has the best children's programming? Who has, I'm told, the best history? PBS.
Sarah Edmonds. Sometimes I was known as Franklin Thompson. I belong to Company F, 2nd Michigan Volunteer Infantry. And history is always looking for an ear to talk to and a medium to tell itself through. And when it finds it, it will tell its story. If you ever watch the end of a rifle, you will see a sheet of flame at least this long, if not longer, come out of every single barrel.
The tone was set that this was not going to be just a couple days of fighting and then everybody going home happy.
Rode into the front of the brigade and said, "Come on, you Wolverines." The men followed me.
Elmwood Cemetery is one of the largest places where Civil War veterans were buried during and following the Civil War in the state of Michigan.
What you're fighting for is not territory. It is for what was called back then hearth and home. And you're fighting for the women, you're fighting for the children, you're fighting for your way of life on both sides. And so the tremendous contribution, I mentioned lumber, the lumbermen made a contribution, obviously agriculture made a contribution in providing food for the Union Army. Michigan's copper industry, which was number one in the country, very important in turning out casings for munitions. There is no level really in which Michigan did not make a significant contribution.
Michigan at that time was the western frontier. You know, we're looking at Michigan just being a new state, only but 24 years old at the time, and a lot of people who were in Michigan became very patriotic and wanted to see a quick resolve of this national catastrophe.
I feel that my job as the First Lady of Michigan was to always support my husband. I tried to look at the small ways that I could assist him to remove the great burden that was on his shoulder at this time. He had taken a great deal of money. He had sent troops to Washington, D.C. President Lincoln wrote a note back saying, "Thank God for Michigan," because Governor Austin Blair had sent the first troops to defend the city of Washington, D.C. And it seemed like that just wasn't enough. He, meaning the president, sent another letter requesting that we send more troops. And the governor felt he just couldn't do it. That Michigan had given its all.
My name is Edward Blakely, and I'm a son of a Civil War veteran, and my dad fought in the Civil War. He joined up with the 10th Michigan Cavalry.
Well, that's significant that even before black soldiers were given equal pay in the war, they signed up and they went to war. And the 102nd from Michigan played an incredible contribution.
Well, it's accomplishment of something that wouldn't have been done otherwise. If someone at a reenactment stops and asks me about Austin Blair, who, let's be honest, is not known to many people at this date, I can explain his role to them and what he did, and the fact that there's a beautiful bronze statue on the lawn of the Capitol building that commemorates his service. And hopefully they'll be a bit more informed, not just about Governor Blair, but about the Civil War, the actions that Michigan men took. There were over 90,000 men from Michigan that took part in the Civil War.
And if I die, won't be in vain. And maybe someday the sacrifice will give a vision to those left behind. And I don't know why, I just keep holding on. Peace in my mind, outside war rages on. By the light of noon, the cavalry will be here soon. Old Michigan seems so far away. In Gettysburg, I saw men die today. And I don't know why, and I just keep holding on. Peace in my mind, and outside war rages on.
Thank God for Michigan. Yes, I recall saying that when the boys from the 1st Michigan came into Washington City.